In this video, we are going to discuss about thread class methods in Java programming language. We know that a thread class is available in lang package. Lang is the default package, so there is no need to import lang package. Without importing lang package, we can use the methods of the thread class. Let's see what are the methods of the thread class. The first one is getId, second one getName, setName, getPriority, setPriority, start method, run method, isAllow method, sleep method, join method, yield method, stop method, wait method, notify method. So all these methods are present in thread class. In this video, we will discuss about getId method, getName method, setName method, getPriority method and setPriority method. In the next videos, we will see the remaining videos, the remaining methods one by one. So here, name of the class is demo thread methods, and this is nothing but main method, public static void main string aux method. Here totally two objects are created for the thread class. ThreadT1 is equal to new thread, and the second object is ThreadT2 is equal to new thread. But here no thread is defined in this class. Why? Because in this example, our target is we have to use just getId, getName, setName, and getPriority and setPriority. So for that, there is no need to define any thread class. In the upcoming videos, we will see how to make use of all those thread classes. Okay. So first one, system.out.println of t1.getId. So let's see what is the use of getId. GetId returns an identification number for the thread. Every thread will have an identification number. So in order to return that identification number, we use getId method. So system.out.println t1.getId. So it returns an integer value. Let us assume that it returns a value called 10. So 10 is the output here. And what is the next method? GetName method. GetName method returns name of the thread. Generally, name will start from 0 onwards. The first thread will be named as thread-0, whereas second thread means thread-1, third thread means thread-2. So likewise, the threads will be named. Let's see an example here. System.out.println of t1. Here we used one more getId method. So t2.getId method. We know that getId method returns an identification number for the thread. Let us assume that here getId returns a value called 11. Now let's see getName method. t1.getName method. So getName method returns name of the thread. So for the first thread, what is the name? Thread-0. Next one, system.out.println t2.getName. For the second thread, what is the name? Thread-1. So likewise, the names will be assigned for the thread. Now let's see the next method, that is getPriority method. GetPriority method returns priority of the thread. Generally, we will have three types of priorities. First one is min priority. First one is min priority, which is denoted by min-priority. Whereas the second one is normal priority. Third one is maximum priority. The minimum priority of a thread is 0, whereas normal priority is 5, maximum priority is 10. So what is the minimum priority? 0, normal priority 5, whereas maximum priority is 10. Okay. So let's see this example. System.out.println t1.getPriority. So what is the normal priority for a thread? The normal priority for a thread is 5. So we will get 5 as the output here. Okay. Or if you display g2.getPriority, then also we will get 5 as the output. Why? Because 5 is nothing but the normal priority of the thread. So whenever we display getPriority method by making use of that thread object, we will get 5 as the output. Next method is setPriority. So by using setPriority method, we can set priority for a thread. Let's see this one. t1.setPriority of 7. Okay. So initially the normal priority is 5. So now that thread priority will be changed to 7. Next, if we want to display that priority, once again we have to use this get priority method. So system.out.println t1.getPriority. So what is the priority that we assigned here? 7. So now we will get 7 as the output. Okay, here we should not write t1.setPriority of 7 within system.out.println. Why? Because setPriority methods allows us to set a priority for the thread. Okay, so that's why we should not write within system.out.println. So initially separately we have to write this statement. So if you want to know the priority of the thread, then once again we need to use get priority method on the corresponding thread object. So here, what is the priority of the thread? 7. So we will get 7 as the output. So this is about get id method, get name method, set name method, get priority method and set priority method. So in the upcoming videos we will see the remaining methods.